गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, हेलो, वेलकम टू द टुडे सेमिनार. एंड टुडे वी हैव अ गेस्ट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ. सो माय नेम इज चित्रांशी रायजादा. आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन पारुल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ आर्ट्स. एंड नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम आवर स्पीकर डॉक्टर फिरोज खान सर. Dr. Firoz Khan is an academic and media expert with over 20 years of experience in the field of media, academics, as well as in IT sector. For the past 20 years, he has been working continuously in the field of technology. Since then, media and education have evolved without interruption of their professional career. At the same time, he also contributing to the heritage and legacy of arts, literature and music. So this is the basic welcome sir, welcome to the PARU through the webinar. And if we are talking about the modern democratic edifice, that modern democratic edifice has been built the principles with the individual liberty of expressions of ideas service as the guiding principle. The concrete form of the expression journalist has risen in the power over the time to the time. Journalism's main goal is to provide news. Sorry for that. Technical issues. Sorry for that. So I'm talking about the journalism's main goal to covering up all these things and to show to the public. But what about the powers and what about the rules for the journalist? Duties, what are the duties of the journalist? Like, what are the restrictions for the journalist? So I am inviting Dr. Firoz Khan sir to please provide us some valuable views on the media laws and ethics. Firoz sir.
Hello, I'm audible to all of you.
Yes, sir. You are now audible.
First of all, thanks, sir. Gratitude towards Chidanshi and Department of Journalism and Mass Communication of PARU University that has given me a chance to interact with the new buddies, or you can say the new infant of students of journalism and media. Because nowadays we can see the power of media, and it is not like that के मीडिया की जो पावर है वो अभी ही है, इट इज फ्रॉम लॉन्ग टाइम बैक ऑल्सो. एंड एज चित्रांशी टोल्ड दैट इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो अबाउट हाउ इट कैन बी यूज इन अ गुड वे, हाउ इट कैन बी यूज इन अ परफेक्ट वे, सो दैट इट कैन बी यूजफुल और डूइंग सम वेलफेयर थिंग्स फॉर द सोसाइटी. एंड चित्रांशी, आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट दिस सेशन विथ वन ऑफ फ्रेज, यू कैन से वन अ शेयर दैट कैन टेल यू अबाउट द पावर ऑफ मीडिया, दैट कैन समराइजेज इन टू लाइन्स द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मीडिया, द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ जर्नलिज्म. एक्चुअली अ वेरी ओल्ड टू लाइन्स ऑफ फ्रेजेस सेड दैट खींचो न कमानों को न तलवार निकालो, खींचो न कमानों को न तलवार निकालो, और जब तोप मुकाबिल हो तो अखबार निकालो. वॉट इट मीन्स एग्जैक्टली सेड बाय दैट अकबर इलाहाबादी, दैट if you are working for media, if you are having a power of journalism, if you are having the power of kalam, if you are having a power of writing, if you are having the power of freedom of speech, then you can win a battle. Then you can fight with anybody in a good way. So that is the power of media, actually. That is the power of journalism, actually. When you are in the field of battle, you are in the field of anything, if you have power of journalism, if you have power of media, if you have sense of that right thing towards doing something for your society, you can win anything. You can do anything. You can mold anything. You can change anything. So this is very good. No two phases line I just gone through. And if you have the power of media, then definitely you should do in a good way. How the way? How to serve the people? How to show the news to the people? How to communicate with the people? That is called a summarization. You call, say, the ethics. That is called ethics media. Media ke kya ethics hain? Kis tarah media ko behtar se behtar banaya jaye? How it can be served in a good way to the students, to the human, to the society? That is summarizing, you can say, it is ethics. So this is a wonderful chance for me to say something about media field, say something about media ethics. I worked in a media house from last 10-12 years. I worked as an academician also. So जितना भी मुझे पता है मीडिया के बारे में, आई एम नॉट सेइंग आई एम सो मच एक्सपर्ट एंड परफेक्ट इन ऑल थिंग्स, जितना भी मुझे मीडिया के बारे में पता है, जितना भी डे बाय डे वी आर गोइंग थ्रू विद द न्यूज, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू विद द प्रोग्राम्स, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू विद द रिपोर्टर्स, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू विद द जर्नलिस्ट, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू विद सम अनवॉन्टेड थिंग्स दैट वी आर फेसिंग एक्चुअली इन द मीडिया. सो आई विल डेफिनेटली ट्राई टू सम अप ऑल द थिंग्स. It's a huge topic, actually. Media ethics, media personal journalist responsibilities, media laws, media responsibility. It's a huge, huge topic, Chitranshi. So,
yes, sir.
So it take maybe 2 or 3 or 4 sessions to complete this in the complete way. But,
yes, sir. Definitely.
Try to sum up all the things. Try to touch all the things which is definitely know by a journalist, which is definitely known by a media person, whether he is doing reporting, whether he is doing anchoring, whether he is in the field, whether he is in the desk, where is in the studio, whether he is on the news portal. There are some special things in the media person. So I will just try to touch all the things with my small presentation. So I will start my presentation in between. If you have something to ask me in between, or maybe if you have something,
no sir, I will ask Henry at the end of this session. If any student or any someone want to ask you a question, then they can leave on comment section. So we can ask, I can ask question at the last of this webinar. You can continue with
your PPT. Okay. And others. So now I'm just starting my presentation and try to sum up
all the things
with my presentation. Okay. Hello, are you able to see my presentation?
No, sir.
Just a second. Just a second. Now you can see my screen. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm visible on the screen or not?
No, sir, you are not visible on the screen, only your PPT is visible.
Okay, Chindarshi. So these are, this is the starting slide of our presentation, media laws and ethics. So if we talk about ethics, what are ethics actually? The ethics actually, it is a word from the, you know, generated from the Greek word ethos, which is basically gives you an idea or a skill by which you can identify, by which you can determine, by which you can take a decision, okay, whether this is a right thing or this is a wrong thing, or this is a doable or this is a not doable thing. This is the ethics actually. Ethics को हिंदी में बोलते हैं नैतिक. नैतिकता हमें वो सिखाती है कि जीवन में क्या सही है, क्या गलत है, क्या ये चीज हमें करनी चाहिए, क्या ये चीज हमें नहीं करनी चाहिए. इसका जो फैसला है, the decision, what is wrong, what is right, it is taken by your ethics actually. And how you can generate your ethics? The ethics belongs to your religious beliefs. आप किस तरह सांस्कृतिक आचरण में पले बड़े हैं, how much you are grown up, what is your environment, what is your संस्कार, what is your family background, what is your personal experiences actually. What, there are some laws and organizational values also that can give you an idea about the wrong, right, bad, good things. In general, it is ethics. नैतिक आचरण ही हमें नैतिक ethics सिखाते हैं कि क्या चीज सही है और क्या चीज गलत है. ये है ethics. If you are talking about media actually, कि media की ethics में जरूरत क्यों है और मीडिया के कौन कौन से एथिक्स है. देयर आर टू मेन एक्चुअली एथिकल थ्योरीज व्हिच आर फ्रीक्वेंटली एम्प्लॉयड टू डिटरमाइन द मीडिया बिहेवियर. वन इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनलिज्म एंड सेकंड वन इज डियोंटोलॉजी. एथिक्स क्या है, मीडिया के एथिक्स क्या है, जिनके द्वारा और बाय विच द डिसीजन और द थिंग कैन बी गो इन टू द राइट और रॉन्ग एरिया. ऐसी क्या चीजें हैं मीडिया में जो मीडिया बिहेवियर को तय करता है. तो दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन मेनली ऑन टू थ्योरीज, दैट इज कॉन्सिक्वेंशियलिज्म थ्योरी एंड डियोंटोलॉजी थ्योरी. बेसिकली कॉन्सिक्वेंशियल थ्योरीज होल्ड द एथिकल वैल्यूज ऑफ एन एक्शन शुड बी जज ऑन इट्स कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज. एक्चुअली क्या परिस्थितियां वो रही, क्या वो हालात रहे जिनकी वजह से ये निर्णय लिया गया. बेसिकली दैट इज कॉन्सिक्वेंशियल थ्योरीज focus only on the outcome of an action. उन परिस्थितियों वश जो एक outcome आया है, what are the results due to that consequences, it is basically defined in the consequentialism theory. And if you go for the deontology theory, it basically tell about the action, why it, this action has been taken. That in generally a deontology theory defines actually कि वो निर्णय क्यों लिया गया, वो उनका एक्शन क्या रहा. दिस इज द बेसिकली एक्चुअली टू थ्योरीज दैट इज फॉर द मीडिया बिहेवियर. एक्चुअली मीडिया में ही इतने एथिक्स क्यों है. एक्चुअली दिस इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इन फ्रंट राइट नाउ. इन देयर इज अनदर फील्ड्स आल्सो, देयर इज आईटी फील्ड आल्सो, देयर इज सम business sector also, the financial sector also, but media ethics की बात, media ethics की बात इतनी क्यों important है. नैतिक आचरण हमेशा media में ही इतना ज़्यादा क्यों ढूँढा जाता है. Why it is so important? If you are compare the field wise, the media ethics so much important. Why? Why it is so important? Basically, actually media is a watchdog of the society. Actually, media एक वो स्रोत है या सोर्स है. देर आर सो मेनी मीडियम्स ऑफ मास मीडिया लाइक टीवी, रेडियो, न्यूज़पेपर्स. नाउ डेज वी कैन सी द सोशल मीडिया ऑल्सो. सो देर आर यू नो बॉम्बार्डिंग ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन टुवर्ड्स द यूजर और कस्टमर ऑफ द सोसाइटी. सो एक्चुअली इट इन्फ्लुएंसेस और नॉट. एक्चुअली the main answer of this question is that mass media or mass communication or media influences the society a lot. It is the news by the people for the people. which basically shape your society. That is very important. The thing you are spreading to the society, you are getting back to the society. So why it is so important? Ethics in the media field, because you are influencing a lot of people by your one news. You are influencing a lot of minds with your one breaking news. You are influencing lot of personality by your one statement. So it is very much careful. You have to be very careful about your ethics. You have to be very conscious about your decision. You have to be very authentic about your things which you are going or which you are spreading or which you are giving into the field or to society or the country or the nation, because it influences a lot. That is why media ethics is so much important. So what are some basic things? What are some conflicts you can say? What are some issues you can say? What are some factors you can say that hurt the ethical issues of the media actually? Right now we have seen so much things about around us. We have seen so much issues around us. We have seen so much ethical deviation around us. So I just tried to write some major issues you can say, or major factors you can say, or major things you can say that actually hurts the ethical issues, actually deviation of the ethical issues due to those factors. Ye kuch karan keh sakte hain, kuch karak keh sakte hain. You can say these are some things by which a media person or media houses or reporter or journalist deviate from their basic part to the other part. The one first of thing I just want to give an idea about conflict of interest actually. Nowadays we can see that media houses have some other organizations also, other works also. They are not running only a news channel, they are not running a newspaper, they are not running a small radio station, they have other things also. So in such circumstances, an independent minded reporter while writing the news story objectively actually, us waqt ye dekha jata hai ki agar hamare kuch interest kuch aur hain, kuch hamare businesses aur hain, kuch hamare issues kuch aur hain, then there is a minor deviation of our ethical news reporting, and that deviate our ethical things in the wrong way, then it should not be done. So this is conflict of interest. आमतौर पर ये चीज देखी जा रही है कि मीडिया हाउस इज नॉट स्टैंड अलोन, स्टिल इज सिंगल यूनिट एक्चुअली. दिस इज वन एथिकल इशू. द सेकंड थिंग इज बायस एंड सब्जेक्टिविटी. एज आई टोल्ड यू इन आवर फर्स्ट पॉइंट, देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स व्हाइल रिपोर्टिंग द थिंग्स, देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स व्हिच इन्फ्लुएंस द न्यूज, देयर आर सो मेनी फैक्टर्स दैट इन्फ्लुएंस द थिंग्स. सो द सब्जेक्टिविटी इज लेजिटिमेटली इनकॉर्पोरेटेड into the journalism. A reporter have their own biasness also. The media house has their own biasness also. They have their subjectivity. So they are unfortunately involved in the reporting sense also. They are involved into the presentation also. So these things definitely, you know, have an issue with our media ethics actually. So these are major two issues we can see all around the other environment. How much type or what type of news we are getting right now, this is actually a very, you know, sensitive thing right now also, because something is you are taking from the media, you don't know how it is reported, how it is written, how, what are the factors which influence this news. So these are major two things by which the ethical issues hurt definitely. Another factor that is called news source confidentiality. Generally what happens that in-depth stories or investigation reporting or anything which is depend on the reporter's confidentiality is always have some parameter of error actually. How much you have believe on that news source, because every news has to be correct in 100% actually. If there is 1% of error, then definitely this news will not be completely correct. So sometimes what happened that the news source is very much important while creating the news actually. कहाँ से वो न्यूज आई, न्यूज सोर्सेस कहाँ है, वो कितना ऑथेंटिक है. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर राइट नाउ फॉर क्रिएटिंग द न्यूज, फॉर प्रेजेंटिंग द न्यूज, कि योर न्यूज सोर्स विल बी 100% करेक्ट फॉर द सीरियस एथिकल कंसर्न हैव बीन रेज्ड इफ देयर इज अ 0.01% एरर ऑफ न्यूज सोर्स कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. एंड नाउअडेज अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी हैव सीन सम स्पॉन्सर्ड न्यूज कैटेगरी ऑल्सो इन विच सम यू नो big celebrities, big organizations, high businessmen, some political leaders, some other peoples are, you know, having some sponsored news categories also on the paper, in the newspaper, in the media houses also. So it is unfortunate, a bitter fact right now in the media field that we are seeing right now, okay, there is some things that is, you know, hurt the ethical things. But another thing is, you know, sting operation. Some media houses or some other newspaper also trying to do some sting operation. In one level, actually, it is right actually. But if you are trying to do in the beyond of the your limitations, then that will a serious impact on your media ethics actually. And one important thing which I just want to mention, that is infiltration into privacy actually. This is a major issue right now. We can see some news media houses, some reporters, some television news channel always try to cross their limit to have the sensational news, to have the, you know, some, you can say, masala news, and cross their limits and go into the private life of politicians, of big celebrities. And so I think news media person should avoid such ventures, at least they are caught in the wrong food actually. So these are some ethical issues. So in any sense or in any way, the media houses and media reporters, journalists are having maybe in major or minor these issues that hurt the media ethics. So one media house or one news journalist, one news reporter should avoid jitna ho sake, as much as possible, avoid these things and be on their ethics. That will be good for himself also or for his media house also. So these are some ethical issues. If you're talking about addressing ethical issues, some of the concerns, some of the organization establishes, not in India, they are in the USA, they're in the UK or Britain or everywhere. So if you're talking about the Society of Professional Journalists, these are the prominent organization in the society in the USA dedicated to encouraging the free practice of journalism and stimulating high standard of ethical behavior. Is tarah ki societies jo hain jo USA mein hain, agar hum India ki baat kare, if you are talking about India, Indian Federation of Working Journalists and National Union of Journalists, these are some organization in India working for the ethical journalism. They are trying to resolve these ethical issues. Most of these codes include ethical journalism should be objective or accurate. Is tarah ki kuch sansthaen hain jo India mein bhi kaam kar rahi hain, jo US mein bhi kaam kar rahi hain, where ethical journalism should be in the practice. Kis tarah ek ethical journalism ke sath sath एथिकल जर्नलिज्म बहुत महत्वपूर्ण हो गया है आज. एथिकल जर्नलिज्म, सही तरह से खबरों को पहुंचाना, अपने एथिक्स पर बने रहना. सो दीज आर सम सोसाइटीज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डेफिनेटली वर्किंग हार्ड टू कम बैक टू ऑन द राइट पाथ अगेन टू हैव द करेक्ट न्यूज. इन USA, इंडिया, देयर आर टू मेन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन इंडियन फेडरेशन ऑफ वर्किंग जर्नलिस्ट एंड नेशनल यूनियन ऑफ जर्नलिस्ट, working very fine to have ethical journalism. This is very important slide of this presentation. Generally, we have gone through daily with our many of news reporters working in Rajasthan, UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, any state actually. So how much they have the right how much they have intervened in the news, how much they have to have the data from the field, what are the restrictions. So these are some important things one should know before going into the field actually, because these are some wings, these are some, you can say, beats. हमारे यहाँ पे हम देखते हैं कि हमारे कुछ रिपोर्टर्स हैं जिनको हमने अलग अलग बीट दे रखी है. दे हैव द डिफरेंट बीट्स. वन इज वर्किंग फॉर सम कल्चरल एक्टिविटीज, वन द पूरी टीम इज वर्किंग फॉर सम स्पोर्ट्स न्यूज, वर्किंग फॉर सम बिजनेस न्यूज, सम पॉलिटिकल न्यूज, एंड दे हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट विंग्स. सो दे हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट रिस्ट्रिक्शंस, दे हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट ओपिनियंस टू टॉक टू द पीपल टू हैव द न्यूज, to collect the data from the field, and they have their restrictions. So these are some ethics, these are some important things or beats on which you have to be sure, you have to be perfect, you have to be very conscious about reporting on the things, about creating the news, about presenting the news. So these are very important beats, these are very important, you can say, you know, beats on reporting politics and election. This is very important nowadays. What happened nowadays, you can say very easily that the hardest or the toughest beat of right now, that is reporting on politics, reporting on politicians, reporting on elections actually. The reports on politics are most often hard news for any media house or any newspaper actually. This section of news attract the highest reader in our country or in any country, you can say. Many of the people, maximum of the people want to news, want to have the data about news of politics actually. So one should be very aware, one should, the reporter should be very conscious about to have, to create the news, to taking the data from the politics, to taking the data from the elections, to talk to about the politicians, to talk about the leaders actually. One should not like to this kid. This is a, you know, thing which is only the point of view of one party, only a point of view of another party. You have to be very conscious on reporting of politics. You don't have to write to ask those questions which have some another thing in his mind. So they will always tell you what they wanted to tell, but you have to make a limitation of your question. You have to ask those questions which is very much needed to be asked to them. So this is a very hard beat, you can say, or a hard wing to be right now to work on that. So there are some restrictions for that, specifically for the reporting. There are, if you are talking about the pre-poll or exit poll, the Press Council of India advises media houses not to allow their forum to be used for distortion and manipulation of the election, and one should not allow themselves to be exploited by the interested of the parties. That is very important thing. By the Press Council of India has given instructions, has given the instructions for the media houses. Okay, if you are doing pre-poll, if you are doing for the exit poll, that should be very, very clear manner. You have to tell the audience, you have to tell the viewers that what type of survey you have done, what is the size of the sample, where you have taken the data. So that is very important for the reporters or for the editor or for the presenter who are presenting the things of pre-poll and exit poll. If you are reporting the communal things, that is very important. If you are making a news for communal thing, you have to be very conscious that it should not be published before a very, very verification of 100% authentication. It should not be sensationalization. It should not be proactively, it should not be alarming type of headlines. You have to create, you have to present the news in that way so the communal harmony, amity and peace of the society can be maintained. So you should be very aware, you should be very restriction about your, or about your rules, about your duties while you are reporting for the communal issues. If you have the caste related media coverage, definitely you have the same rights, you have the same restrictions. You have not to use any language or any caste-related word that can be done in a wrong way. So it is very important to have, or it is very important to work on the caste-related media coverage. if you are on the financial reporting, if you are doing the financial reporting, it is very important. A recruiter who exposes the things get a good thing on the financial report. Financial matters also involve some basic things from the financial matter from the company also. So one should be very careful by releasing that news, by collating those news, by presenting that news. The data should be 100 times perfect. One of the best example of financial reporting, if you want to see, you can see the now web series that is very popular nowadays, that is a scam. So Chetan Dalal was the first financial reporter who was very you know, keenly worked in that scam in 1992 or 3 or 4, at the era of 90s. So she was a wonderful financial reporter who worked hard night and day to report the things. He was very interested to know the things by his sources of news. He was very, you know, that type of financial reporting done in a good way. So the best example of financial reporting, that you can see the web series, the scam. The same thing, if you are working on investing reporting, you should be very careful about your news sources. You have to be very investigative. You have to check double all the things before creating news, before presenting in that news. Reporting self-serious offenses, you have to be very conscious. You have to be very authentic. You should not reveal the name. You should not reveal the identity of a person. So these are some things. These are specific things. Basically, right now we can see these type of newses always coming from the news channels. So this is the thing when one media person should be very careful, or should be very hardworking and very sensitive also to cover these all things of things. So this is the media rights on all the things. These are some laws and bills that is, you know. Chitranshi, how much time I have?
Sir, you have approx 25 minutes.
Okay, Chitranshi, I just try to sum up actually.
Okay.
So these are.
You have a time approx half an hour, so you can continue.
Okay, Chitranshi, thank you so much. So this is the some bills that or act related to the media portion. If you are working in the media field, definitely you or your media house are facing these type of things. So if you are going into the media field, if you are working into the media field, these are some acts or laws which you or your organization will definitely have a things about this. This is one is defamation right, defamation act actually. Media person, sometimes what happened that a media person or media houses make any remark, make any statement or run any stories that can, you know, infringement on the right to the reputation of an individual. So this is very, you can see also some cases around in the Twitter or around on the Facebook that this celebrity has, you know, do a case of demotion on the any news channel or in a newspaper. So you have to be very careful while giving any comment, while putting any remark for the individual, because they have the right to make a case of defamation on the media houses, on the reporter. So you should be very careful before publishing any news, before giving any remark. You have to make double times check actually. Section number 499 of Indian Penal Code defines defamation actually. So you have to be very careful. Right to privacy, when you are doing this is also act or law which we have seen right nowadays. Okay, one should go and cross their limit and try to catch the news, try to make the sensational news, and try to catch those things they doesn't want to show actually. So that celebrities, that person, that individual, have anybody in the India has right to leave his privacy, not to show anything that he doesn't or she doesn't want to show actually. So there is a guideline from Press Council of India. There is a restrictions. There is a guideline for any reporter not to cross those things until you have that thing that is good for the community or true and communicated in good way for the common good. So otherwise you have a chance to have a act or a case over your media houses. So another is introduction to Copyright Act. Actually, what happened nowadays, we can say many of news channel running or showing one news at one time actually. So Copyright Act always into the scene when you are running or when you are breaking the news or when you are taking the content. So the media person who are working in media houses for portal actually, basically for the portal, and they are taking data, they are having the information from other channel also there. So just try to manipulate things and upload it over the portal also anywhere. So they have to be very conscious. They have to be very careful while writing the data, while making the news, while taking the visuals actually. Somehow what happens ke, right now we have seen thousands of YouTube channels also and newspapers also, and there are some major television national channels also. They have their same, you know, visuals. So sometimes what happened there, they are making in the exclusive format. So you have to be very conscious ke, if a channel has running those visuals or with the tag of exclusive, suppose Aaj Tak exclusive or NDTV exclusive, so it is very difficult. It is not to be take any visuals or data from any news channel that is have their own right, until unless if there is a bonding or there's a communication thing, if there's authority letter from that thing. So you have to be very careful about this. Another presentation of Women Act 1986. This is very important also. Act that is generally media houses or media person not to worry about it, but they have cases like this. You should not be represent women as an object. So you have to be very careful while making news, while showing the cases about women. So should not violate the Indecent Representation of Women Act 1986. And another act is Contempt of Court. That is very important. A media house or media person should tell about the court and their, you know, their cases, but not in that way. So it has to be, it should not be like this disobedience or disregard of court order. You have to be very careful while making news, while running news, while taking data from the court. You should not contempt of court Act 1987. So this is some air policies and broadcasting rules. If you are working in the media in All India Radio, or you are working in the broadcasting media like Doordarshan, there is a guideline for electronic media. This will help professional in the media field to both ethical and creative. You have to be very conscious about working on All India Radio or maybe in the Doordarshan. So this is the guideline that already have given to all the staff, all the media persons. It should not be criticism of our Mitra Desh, which our Mitra Desh is, we can't criticize them. You should not attack on the religion or the community. Koi bhi news banate vakt, koi bhi news chalate vakt, you have to be very conscious while working in the air or in the Doordarshan. Or these are the general ethics also you can have in all the news channels, private news channel also. Because you should not attack on the religion or communities. Hum koi bhi aisi baat na bole, na kahe, jisse kisi ki dharmik bhavna aahat ho. इससे किसी धर्म विशेष पर हम कोई टिप्पणी नहीं कर सकते. तो हम काफी देखते हैं, वी हैव सीन लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स के इस तरह की चीजें हो रही, बट इट इज अवॉइडेड एक्चुअली, इट शुड बी अवॉइड एक्चुअली. कोई भी डिफेमेटरी ऑब्सेंस हम वल्गैरिटी नहीं दिखा सकते हैं. हम कोई भी ऐसी चीज ना बनाए ना दिखाएं. वी शुड नॉट रन एनी टाइप ऑफ प्रोग्राम, एनी टाइप ऑफ फिलर, एनी टाइप ऑफ न्यूज दैट इज अगेंस्ट ऑफ मेंटेनिंग लॉ ऑफ ऑर्डर एक्चुअली. So this is very
that's important. That's why most of the news channels use samudaya vishesh and these type of words and
definitely Chitranshi. So right now unfortunately we have seen actually in these days on the news channel, but it is a conduct of, you know, it's ethical or it has to be stopped. We have, or many of the people have, you know, made some cases on all the channels also that why you are doing this actually. So this is contempt of court actually. This is against of maintenance law of order. So these are some broadcasting code of air policy and the news channels. So these are very important thing. Every new journalist or every person who is trying to go into the field of media has to be very clear about these type of things. One should avoid these all things. So these are broadcasting. Now I'm trying to wrap up the things. This is the Press Council Norms of Journalists Conducted. Section 13 of Press Council Act 1978 suggests formulation of guide for the journalist, guideline for the electronic media management. This will help professionals in the media field to be both ethical and creative. What happens that we are creative, but we have to be ethical. We are ethical, but we have to be creative. This is the double responsibility of the news channel, double responsibility of the media houses, responsibility double for the news reporter, news anchor, the presenter. Accuracy and fairness. Every news has to be accurate. Every news has to be fair in both of the way. We have to be very, very much sure what you are presenting and what you are public or what you are going to broadcast on your channel. That is pre-publication verification. We have to make the privacy right to anybody which you are giving, which you are showing on your channel. Actually, there should not be any defamatory writing that can hurt any people or human. Corrections very important. If you are running wrong news, or if you are having, or if you are publishing any thing or any report or any article which you have a mistake, you have to be correct in our 24 hours or maybe in some news another edition or maybe in the news bulletin of next. Actually, you have to be correct. Actually, everybody, every human or every citizen of India has right to reply, he has the right to ask the questions to you. So you have to answer what you are showing. You have to, you have to reply what you are giving to the society. Actually, vulgarity should be eschewed. Actually, if you have the if you have a need of recording interviews and phone conversation, you have the definitely authentication, or without it concern, you cannot make any conversation. So this is the specific course for the journalist. Actually, if you're talking about the media forms and its freedom, in the initial days of 1456, that is called authoritarian model, in which the fully controlled by the government actually. So at that time there was no such type of thing ke jo bhi government chahti thi, jo bhi sarkare chahti thi, wo authoritarian model mein actually wo log kiya karte the. As the time passes, we have seen the libertarian model, jahan par isko kuch swatantra di gayi actually. Ye banaya gaya ki 1644 around 74 mein libertarian model ki shuruaat hui. उस शुरुआत में बताया गया कि सरकार के होते हुए भी संस्थाएं किस तरह से स्वतंत्र कार्य कर सकती है. सो एट दैट टाइम द मीडिया और प्रेस हैज फाइंड द करेक्ट पाथ एंड हैविंग सम राइट टू से अबाउट द गवर्नमेंट. सो दिस इज द मीडिया फॉर्म्स एट फ्रीडम सेल्फ रेगुलेशन. राइट नाउ वी कैन सी द सेल्फ रेगुलेशन मॉडल वर्किंग, हाउ दे आर इंडिपेंडेंटली ऑपरेट देयर थिंग्स, how they are judging their things, even though they are using the ethical code, ethical norms, journalists are doing things. So right now, this is in the right format. This is the self-regulation mode. You can easily find some more information about these forms of media actually. And if you are saying, if you are having some example of media ethics transgression, kaha hamari media ethics ne apne aap ki seemaye todi. What are the things actually जहां हम अपने रास्ते से भटक गए. Some of the examples, that is Kathua rape case, it's held in Jan 2018 actually, जहां पर इस केस में न चाहते हुए भी मीडिया ने कम्युनल और पॉलिटिकल ओवरटोन को बिल्ड करा, जिसकी वजह से Kathua rape case एक यूं कहे के सांप्रदायिक तनाव के रूप में जम्मू कश्मीर में फैल गया. उसकी वजह से the High Court actually fined 10 lakh rupees on some of the news channel for reporting the other things which is not has to be into the field or has to not into the society. The second example of this media ethics transgression is Arushi Hemraj murder case, in which media is trying to catch the TRP or trying to catch the sensational news, and they are running their parallel trials type of thing. So this is also a bad example of media ethics. And if you remember 2006, there's a case of Prince Borwell case. In that case, every media house, every news channel, every reporter was went there to have the live coverage to see how the army men are working. But there is no need of that type of thing. It has to be only one case. It has to be one news. But in this tape running of, in the competition of 24/7, it makes some sensational news. They breaches, they deviate their path, and they cross their media ethics in these three cases. These three cases are example. And if we are summarizing, this is the last slide of this slide. If we go on to the statement on Gandhiji, what he said on media ethics, or what he said, Hindi में अगर कहूँ तो एक बहता पानी फसलें उगा भी सकता है और पूरे देश को और पूरे खेत को बर्बाद भी कर सकता है. उसी तरह एक मीडिया, एक जर्नलिस्ट एक बहुत अच्छा काम भी कर सकता है अगर वो कंट्रोल तरीके से किया जाए और वो अपने एथिकल वेज में किया जाए तो वो देश की सेवा कर सकता है. लेकिन अगर वो एक डिविएट होके एथिकल इश्यूज एथिकल अपने नॉर्म छोड़ के दिग्भ्रमित होके काम करे तो वो पूरे देश को और पूरे समाज को बर्बाद भी कर सकता है. तो हमें इन मीडिया एथिक्स पे बने रहना है. गांधी जी की इस बात को सदैव याद रखनी है कि कलम की ताकत सबसे बड़ी ताकत है. सो वी शुड मेंटेन अवर मीडिया एथिक्स. सो दिस इज द लास्ट स्लाइड.
ओके सर. सर, वन ऑफ आवर पार्टिसिपेंट आस्क सम क्वेश्चंस लाइक फर्स्ट वन इज व्हाई राइट टू प्राइवेसी बिकम सो इंपॉर्टेंट. As on one side, social media has given people to express them freely. So, which they are doing?
Just a moment. I'm just maximizing my, slide. Are you able to see me?
No, sir.
Just a second. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are visible. One of the participant asked one question that why right to privacy becomes so important, as on one side social media has given people to express them freely, which they are doing.
Actually, the social media has given right to show their private thing. They just wanted to show it actually. Right now, the Privacy Act or privacy is so much important that when a media house or media person or journalist trying to show those things into the channel or into the newspaper, which they don't want to show. If you can say, if it is a, possible, if it is a social welfare of the thing, if it is good for the community, good for the society, then you can show it and you have to prove it, Chidranshi, actually. Otherwise, you cannot have the right to show those things. You have an example of Ranbir and Katrina Kaif images. This is the abolition of the privacy, actually. The couple was on that, their vacation and the maybe any person. This is actually a result of yellow journalism, or you can citizen journalism. Everybody cannot be a journalist, Chitanashi, actually. You have to be very careful while you are taking pics. You have to be very authentic. You have the right to take the pictures. You have to publish the pictures. So it is very, very important to make the, respect of the privacy of others while you are working in the media field.
Yes, sir. Second question is, can't there be a healthy criticism of friendly neighboring countries?
Yeah, we have the right of our neighboring countries, but not in that way. We always have a healthy interaction with Pakistan or Burma or China. But if you are talking about some border things, if you are very talking about border or conflicts, if you are talking about the LOC, if you are talking about the Pakistan, which is doing to us, that is, we have to criticize. And we are criticizing, actually. So that should be in the way. In the correct way, we have to put all the things in the correct way. We have to propose all the things. We have to create news in that way. The thing should be populated into the society in the correct way, always, with our neighbor countries also.
Okay, thank you so much, Feroz sir, for giving us your precious time. And thank you everyone for attending today's webinar regarding media laws and ethics. Especially, I want to thank our technical team, webinar team, Mr. BJ Acharya and Mr. Jiten Khubani for arranging this webinar. Without their efforts, webinar is not possible. So thank you everyone. Thank you, Feroz sir. Thank you everyone who participated in this webinar. Thank you so much. Yes, sir.
Chitrashi,
Yes,
one
sir.
more thing I just wanted to add. I really wanted to thanks to you and your whole team and Paro University and the Department of Journalism that has created that webinar session. And on the in the very specific topic actually, media ethics is very important. Kalam ki taakat sabse badi taakat hai. I have started this session with my phrase,
Yes,
and
sir.
I'm ending this session with one of phrase that is
Sure,
with
sir.
the power of a कलम, with the power of journalism, उदासी के चेहरे पे खुशियां लिखे. हमारे पास में वो ताकत है एक्चुअली, मीडिया की ताकत है, कलम की ताकत है.
जी
उदासी के चेहरे पे खुशियां लिखे और कलम हाथ में लेके दुनिया लिखे. तो आपके और हमारे साथ में कलम की ताकत है, इनसे हम दुनिया लिख भी सकते हैं, हम बदल भी सकते हैं. तो आप सभी लोगों के लिए यही मेरी तरफ से राय कह लीजिए कि आप सभी इस कलम की ताकत को समझें और इस ताकत को सही दिशा में लगाएं. थैंक यू सो मच.
ओके थैंक यू सो मच सर.